Hello everyone and welcome to our Return to the Scout episode. We will try the new Scout. And yeah, we have improved health and impenetrable, which is, as far as I heard, a really good perk now that definitely shows something. We also have better energy regeneration, so we can easily just immediately regenerate our full energy. Can just immediately have it back with just a single second. The whole bar is completely filled up after a few plasma caster shots while being invisible. So, also I hear many people complaining the new pet is too OP. However, I wouldn't say that that's the truth, because I just had a match, I didn't record it unfortunately. And yeah, I had a match where I actually got defeated as Pelta, because there was a full actually communicating OBLF team. Let's alert them. As far as I know, you can alert them by shooting plasma caster shots, but I'm not 100% sure about that. I don't think it works or works anymore, but I heard that it should work. I mean, it alerts them definitely that I shoot them, but yeah, the new OVFL agent is really good when played in a team altogether. He is meant to be able to kill the Predator. His complete class is designed to do that. And oh, hello there. I'm really curious about the damage I will get with the Scout and Impenetrable, since Scout is the weakest class health wise and Impenetrable should be really good now, and my aim is still terrible, so we will use this match as training. Will you come out? Okay, let's go closer, and she jumped off. I hate you. I still don't want to get too close, but yeah. Someone found my location. And you are dead, so okay. This is the new weapon. I heard that the new weapon has not good damage, and I see what I mean. Or Impenetrable is just dead OP. Oh my god, that was no damage. And yeah, I forgot about that. You see what they shoot, they basically have motion detectors now. Fire team has motion detectors. Not as OP as you think, considering the fact how long you can stay in cloak with the new 2-point perk. Well, it's not new, but updated perk, energy reserves. Because what it does, should focus more on my aiming, but yeah, what it does, it regenerates while you use an ability. So it reduces automatically the cost of your ability. So we don't really need Lightbender to lower the cost of our cloak, because fast energy regeneration does that already. And yeah, why do we hit... What? And why did my arrow just be 11 meters in the wrong direction? But was that a one hit? How much health did she have? Because do headshots one hit now once more? Or is it just a hidden ability for the Scout? Does the Scout just more range damage with downrange and can one shot? I don't know. And my aim is terrible. Probably because I talk too much. And I'm way too hyped for these new challenges, because it's actually fun now to play. And they lowered the matchmaking time for Predator. I don't know how they managed that. You would now think that because Predator is actually now strong, that everyone would play him, but the Predator queue is between 3 and 5 minutes. Sometimes it bugs out and you have infinite connecting, then you just have to cancel and search for a new match. But yeah, where is your friend? I mean, I will let you reinforce because you weren't that good.
Ooh. There it is.
Okay, is that heavy hitter or just the knife damage? Because he does a lot of damage with his fucking knife. A red dust downrange, that will not help you. You know that I can see you through that vision. Yeah, he knows. Yeah, but I will let them reinforce. I wonder. Was that a pig? You know what? You can go. Where was the pig? That's a barrel. Where did the pig go, Dutch? Where did the pig go? Let's collect our arrows while we are waiting for them to reinforce. Because that was way too easy. But yeah, fireteam can be dangerous and kill you. That's the pig. If they play together and make their loadouts fitting for each other. I had a OVF team that talked to each other and had loadouts fitting for the situation. One OVF agent had more healings, but the other one had more ammunition, and so you're supposed to play. You should create loadouts that you can use with other people's loadouts so that they work together. And the damage reduction can be stacked as far as I have seen for the OVF agent, and it's really, really good against just plasma caster abusers like me. But yeah, you will definitely tank a lot of range damage. So harassing, she just spawned and got an arrow in the face. I feel bad for her. But they are not that dumb, they destroy those barrels if they think that I will use them, but I will probably not use them because I already... She just died one hit. She was full health. I mean, it was a scout, I think, but did they improve the bow damage, or is it just a range damage boost with downrange together for the scout only? More motion detectors. If we walk through that or move inside of them, we will get spotted. And it will spot spammers while we move in them. I can walk. Yeah, you can see I moved inside of them. You can stand still in them, will not get spotted by them, but if you move, you will get spotted. It basically works the same as the predator ones, however, they don't spot you for as long, and I completely fucked it up. I'm playing on the highest sensitivity since I want to get used to that, and just playing on the highest one. So yeah, I'm not used to play on high sensitivity with the bow. So excuse my bad aim. But yeah, as you can see, if we move even slightly, we get spot spammed. Also, if we leap in and out of them, we get spotted from those, but it's not that long, so it's pretty fine. Considering the fact that we can have unlimited cloak, and you can see how long the cloak is. I have the only energy perk I have is the new reserve. That's what helps my cloak so much currently, so yeah, I guess this perk will become meta. Just because of that, and you can see how fast I regenerate energy. It's only slow if I have a bigger battery, and those are all AI. Let's show off the plasma cast and how it works with this energy. Yeah, you can easily collect much more energy, but impenetrable definitely shows here its strength. Because you can see I don't take much damage. Even though I am Scout, the weakest class basically, health-wise, and he is down. So let's collect this body. You can also have the new perk Iron Sight for the Predator that makes damage go even down further. If you get hit from behind while you move or claim or stealth kill. And I heard that that one is really OP, pretty good for running away, and it allows you to easily claim. I will test it out later with a tank Zerg. The Zerg is completely based on tanking damage. I have impenetrable and the new perk Iron Sight on him, so we will see how much damage we tank. We're still there, aren't you? No, let's stay up here. I have the high ground. But I don't think impenetrable is 2P because you will still take a lot of damage from 4 players, but single player, especially using a weapon that's not that good like the new one, they will have big problems fighting you. come out, Dutch. Ah, he comes out on his own. They really want to fight, even though they know they lose. But they feel like they can defeat me because I'm Scout. And that's it. Scout is just so good with impenetrable. It's just so good. I will definitely return to my main, the Scout. I can return to her, because she's not terrible anymore. Come here, my lovely Dutch. But yeah, it's not unbalanced if you play together. What's the fire team supposed to do? Which is bad for solo queue players, but still, it's a team-based game. Just like Rainbow Six Siege, you will also not have the most success just running off on your own unless you're actually really good, but this is not Rainbow Six Siege, and it's actually balanced right now. They also have this proximity mine launcher, so I guess that was this thing, that the motion detector is the proximity mine launcher. I thought of it as a mine launcher that it just shoots explosive, but I think I was wrong. Those seem to be really those motion detectors. So they can refill with ammo. However, you need to really place them smartly, because they have the same range as the proximity mines that the Predator has, and it's not the very best considering the movability of the Predator. Let's see what we have here. Obviously just blues. Yeah. However, that's the end of the video. Thank you for watching. Next will be a Zerg tank build test. I mainly focus on being really aggressive, and we will see how much damage we can tank. We'll see you in the next video. Have a nice day.